traders, Philip Taggesen here from Stock Market Strategy. Before I start, I just want to say that trading involves risk and hard work, so please do your own due diligence before trading real money. Today I'm going to talk about Bollinger Bands. I will give you some background information about Bollinger Bands and then show you some charts so you can see what this indicator is all about. Finally, I will give you some tips about how to best use Bollinger Bands in conjunction with other indicators and or chart analysis. If you go to our website www.stock-market-strategy.com, you will find a tab called Education, Technical Analysis and Bollinger Bands. Here you will find a written summary including several charts showing you how to use Bollinger Bands in trading. This is made to make it easy for you to keep track of the information. You might even print this page out so you can have it in front of you while writing your trading plan or backtest the idea shown here. Bollinger Bands were developed by John Bollinger and fast became one of the most popular and used overlays. Bollinger Bands are used to determine the volatility of a stock or a future or any other instrument you want to trade. It consists of a simple moving average, together with an upper and lower band, calculated by using a 2 standard deviation from the moving average. During high volatility, the bands will expand, you see this here, and here. During a low volatility, the bands will contract, predicting a substantial move. You see that move here. The problem with the Bollinger band is it doesn't tell us if the move is going to be up or down. Because the bands contain most of the price action, a move to the upper band can be seen as overbought, or a move to the lower band can see as oversold. What length to choose? John Bollinger recommends a 20 period moving average. This is based on daily charts, so intraday traders should not necessarily follow this. You have to backtest and forward test which setting suits you best. Now I'll show you how to use Bollinger Band in trading. Here's another way to use Bollinger Band for a trading signal. I first identify the trend. I see that my MA are relative sideways and price are crossing down and up through the MA. This indicates we got sideways price action. That means I can go both short and long. I then look for a move to the upper Bollinger Band for an overbought signal and a move to the lower Bollinger Band for an oversold signal. If the settings are correct on your Bollinger band, you'll experience that it will contain 90% of the price action. This indicates that we can expect a move between the two Bollinger bands. This gives us an entry and an exit. And third, I'm going to wait for my entry signal. Here you see a bar moving outside the Bollinger band. This is going to be my trigger bar. When I get a close underneath this bar, I can go short. It happens here. I then put my target in at the opposite Bollinger band, around here. Here we see a bar moving outside the Bollinger band. That's going to be my new trigger bar. But because I don't see any bar closing above my trigger bar immediately afterwards, I'm going to ignore that signal. I like quick rejections of the Bollinger band. I get that around here. I get a move down outside the Bollinger band and then I will wait for a close above my new trigger bar, which happens here. I then put in my target at the opposite Bollinger band. You see these signals many times in sideways price action and they're really good to trade. Here's a great Bollinger band setup for breakout traders. It works well on intraday charts and on daily charts. First, I want to identify the trend. I can see that the MA is upsloping and I see that price is staying relative above it, so the trend is up, meaning I will only take long plays. Second, I'm going to look for a Bollinger band squeeze. That's when the bands contract. We got one here, a second one here, and a third one here. Third, I'm going to look for my signal. I'm waiting for the bar to close above last swing pivot high inside the squeeze, this high. Over here, my signal is a close above last swing pivot high inside the squeeze, this high. The last one, I'm looking for the close above the last swing high inside the squeeze, this high. I don't like this third setup that much. I consider the price already moved too much, giving me a bad risk to reward. My target will be smaller and my stops are bigger. The Bollinger Band Squeeze increases the quality of your breakout trees because it's a predicted a strong move, making it easier for you to trail your stop and or reaching your target. It's easy to see the strong move after the squeeze happening here and here. This is one of the reasons why the Bollinger Band Squeeze is my favorite breakout trade. Here's an advanced but very powerful setup using Bollinger Band Squeeze. First, look for a Bollinger Band Squeeze. We got one here. Second, look for a failed attempt of a taking out a prior high after the Bollinger Band Squeeze breakout. We're climbing here, but we failed to take out this high over here to the left. Third, look for a close underneath the Bollinger Band Squeeze low. We have it occurring here. This setup is very powerful because it feeds on other traders' financial and emotional pain. This is because the traders who went long after the Bollinger Band Squeeze breakout over here is now in a losing position and it will result in a quick drop. Here's a Bollinger Band setup combined with RSI. First, I'll be looking at price at the upper Bollinger Band or at the lower Bollinger Band. Second, I'll be looking at RSI divergence. Price making a higher high, while RSI makes a lower high. Here price are making a lower low, while RSI makes a higher low. Third, I'd be looking for the signal. Here I got a bar closing underneath the prior three lows. I can go short. Here I got a bar closing above the prior three bars. I can go long. This ends today's video. I hope you've enjoyed it. Thank you.